everyone to Gardner-Edgerton High School, where this afternoon the 10-1 Trailblazers will take on the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South. Hello, everyone. I am Chuck Holmes, and welcome back for another beautiful day here at the Trailblazers, fresh off of a tournament victory over the weekend, where they swept through the DeSoto baseball tournament and came away with the champions. They will start tonight at 10-1, still ranked number 2 in the state in 6A. The Raiders come in today at 2-4. We'll start off with our star player. We're going to highlight one player today. We're going to highlight Ty Wood. Ty's a senior. Plays out in center field. Heck of a ball player. Hits from both sides of the plate, left side and right side. Comes in hitting at about 281. And, my bad. You know what? I was highlighting the wrong guy. And I don't know why I'm highlighting Ty. But we're going to highlight Hayden Dyer today. Also a senior. And Hayden comes in at hitting at an even 500. So that's awesome to see in itself. So look at our starters as they Trailblazers start to take the field here a little bit. We're going to go from left to right, starting out in left field. Out in left field will be Logan Ringle. Out in left field will be Jake McClure. In center field, we're going to have Ty Wood. Out in right field, we're going to have Landon Turner. Over at third base, it'll be the third baseman Austin Bowie. Hitting, and at shortstop will be Hayden Dyer. Carson Schrack at second base, Dawson Williams at first, Tyler Butash behind the plate, and Zach Sanford will be on the hill. Some upcoming events that we have coming up here for the on our Trailblazer Network here. Starting on August 22nd, we've got more softball as the Lady Trailblazers will take on the team from I lost my notes here. The wind's blowing all over the place, so I got notes everywhere. So they'll be taking on Mill Valley, April 27th, more softball as they take on Free State. And then on May 11th, more baseball. All the action can be seen here on GEHS on TV, only on GEHS TV on live streams 1 and 2. So we'll be back with the start of the game after this break.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
When it comes to higher education, Johnson County Community College delivers more for your money. More opportunities to learn outside the classroom, more interaction with caring instructors, more personalized attention with supportive student services. Discover more at JCCC. Change your life through learning. Change your life at Johnson County Community College. Call 913-469-3803 or visit jccc.edu to learn more.
And welcome back here to Trailblazers Stadium as the Trailblazers prepare to take on the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South. Raiders, as I mentioned earlier, Raiders are coming off of a weekend where they won 3 games, scoring a total of 34 runs, averaging about 11 runs a game in the DeSoto tournament. They walked away with 3 victories, which made them 10-1. Last league game, Trailblazers lost to Olathe West 3-2. And so we'll see if they can't get back on the winning ways when it comes to the league as well. Once again, the wind blowing out of the north. Kind of a brisk breeze blowing out of the north, so anything hitting the air is going to get knocked down, especially out to left field. And so outfielders, the wind's going to play havoc with them. So it behooves the pitchers, if they want to pitch fly balls, they have to really, outfielders really have to be on their game. At the beginning of the game, we also highlighted Dyer. And Dyer comes in hitting at an even 500. So nice to see him start to heat back up. And I also mentioned Bowie over at third base. He's coming out of his slump. He's now hitting 200, which didn't sound like a lot, but when he was hitting 077, so he's really come up out of his slump. So leading it off, for the Raiders will be Christian Hampton, left fielder. And he takes ball one. Raiders come in at 2-4, having lost their last two. Pitches inside for ball two. Zach Sanford on the hill for the Trailblazers. Takes that pitch high for ball three. Sanford puts one right in there for strike one. And that pitch is right in there for strike two. So Zach able to battle back to even the count. Three balls and two strikes here in the top of the first inning. And the pitch, swung back, foul straight back. And here comes the 3-2. Curveball swung on and missed. So Zach able to come back from being down in the count 3-0 to come back to strike out Christian Hampton.
Now batting for the Raiders, the center fielder, number 3, Skylar Ray.
And we'll bring up the center fielder, Skylar Ray. Here comes the pitch. And that pitch is high and inside for ball one. That pitch is high for ball two. Over the weekend, the Raiders had, not the Raiders, but the Trailblazers had a really good series. They were able to win the DeSoto tournament. And that pitch is swung on, fly ball to left field. McClure is there, takes it in the glove for out number two. So two up and two down.
Now batting for Sean Mason South.
It's gonna bring up
the pitcher and designated hitter,
Miles McKenna.
Miles McKenna.
McKenna comes up hitting from the right side of the left side of the plate. Pitch. Just a bit outside for ball one. There's a pitch just a little bit outside. So once again, Zach behind in the count. Been behind all three hitters so far. 3-0. To the pitcher and designated hitter, Miles McKenna. Spencer Hill on deck. Man, that pitch is right in there for strike one. Still a hitter's count. Here comes the pitch. And swung on and missed. So once again, Zach has battled back from a 3-0 count to even the count at three balls and two strikes. Here comes the 3-2. And that pitch is fouled away. Nice crowd here tonight. This afternoon, nice crowd come over from Shawnee Mission South. Cheer on the Raiders. 3-2. And that ball is skied straight up. And Dawson's calling for it. And he's able to make the catch, fighting the win. So after one half inning, three up and three down. Raiders nothing. Trailblazers coming to bat.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents. I got into this because I was a sufferer. I turned into my dad, but I came back. And I'm here to help others come back. This is my baby right here. Dr. Rick, I'm becoming your parents. It came about where my parentology thoughts, I was coming up with so many of them, I thought, I don't need to just have this, the world should have it. So I just birthed it, you know, right out of me. Sometimes we have a victory and I relish those.
Probably need a hacksaw at some point.
Nope.
But most of the time we don't.
General rule of thumb, we throw pillows. If there's nowhere to sit, you have too many.
Parentology is not an officially recognized field yet, but I think we're making strides in that direction. You just have to keep reminding them you are your own person. You're not your parents. You're you.
Welcome back to Gardner-Hinton High School. I'm Chuck Holmes here on GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports. Trailblazers coming to bat after Zach Sanford able to get the Raiders in order at the top of the first inning. Leading off for the Trailblazers will be Ty Wood. Left-hander on the mound, Skylar Ray for the Raiders. A couple of televised games, the Raiders have had a hard time with the lefties. So we'll see if they can figure out Skylar Ray here early. Ty Wood coming to the plate. Ty's hitting 281. He's got two home runs with 11 RBIs. And here comes the first pitch. And there's a ground ball to short. Ty hustling down the line. Longer throw by Rodriguez is able to get him. So one pitch and one out. McClure comes to the plate now. McClure comes in hitting 415, lefty against lefty matchup. Takes the first pitch for strike one. Jake has no home runs, but he's got 16 RBIs, and there's a ground ball to third. Third baseman comes up, throws across the diamond just in time to catch Jake. So now they're two away on two ground balls.
Now up for Gardner-Hinton, the shortstop, number four, Hayden Dyer.
That's going to bring Hayden Dyer up to the plate. As I mentioned earlier, Hayden's hitting a solid 500. He's got two home runs, 11 RBIs. And he takes the first pitch for a ball for strike one, for ball one. Hayden's the type of player that has all the tools. And there's a pop-up out to shallow right field. Everybody's running. Right fielder is able to make the catch as he's battling the wind. So the Trailblazers go quietly here in the bottom of their half of the first inning. So after one complete, it's 0-0.
Food is life. It's the building blocks of our amazing bodies. Food is strength. It powers us in the pursuit of our full potential. Food is energy. It fuels our accomplishments, big and small. It nourishes us in mind, body, and spirit. Food is health, fitness, and our future. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows. Price Chopper. Food is life. It's the building blocks of our amazing bodies. Food is strength. It powers us in the pursuit of our full potential. Food is energy. It fuels our accomplishments, big and small. It nourishes us in mind, body, and spirit. Food is health, fitness, and our future. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows. Price Chopper.
And we're back here at Gardner-Hinton High School, where after one inning, it's scoreless between the Trailblazers and the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South. Zach Sanford on the hill for the Trailblazers. Able to retire the Raiders in the first inning in order. Here's the catcher up, Spencer Hill. And gets one right back to Zach. Zach walks over, tosses it over to first base, and there's one away.
Now batting for Shinerson South, the first baseman, number 35, Jackson are up.
One of the things we recently started here on GEHS TV is a trivia question. And after this pitch here, we'll try to get that trivia question in for you, show you the location where you can actually go out and submit your answer with an opportunity to win a $10 gift certificate to Quick Trip. Billy Schuf at the plate, pops one up to right field, traveling to foul territory. The wind's pushing it, and the ball's out of play. Trupp is the first baseman for the Raiders. And that pitch is right in there for strike three. As Zach gets his second strike out of the game.
Now batting, the third baseman, number 8, Billy Schuf.
First pitch is in there for a ball. Count it 1-1. Well, Zach ahead in the count, or even with the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes to the first baseman, Billy Schuf. And that pitch is swung on, fouled back. Count stays at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Pitch is fouled straight back as well. So, 3 balls and 2 strikes on the Raiders' first baseman. And that ball is hit to right field as Landon Turner is able to get a bead on it, brings it in. Once again, Raiders are retired here in the top of the second inning. We'll go to a break, 0-0.
I'm Lieutenant Adam Winters, the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Highway Patrol public resource officers across the great state of Kansas have a message for you.
3 out of every 4 car seats are installed incorrectly. Please read your owner's manual and vehicle manual to learn how to install your car seat correctly.
When driving on Kansas highways and you see a trooper in a safety vest and you see the orange cones, you're in a construction zone. Please remember, slow down, don't drive distracted, and move over. It's Kansas law.
Now that you've seen us, make sure you see us and all other first responders and road workers. Move over.
On behalf of everyone in our community and in healthcare, thank you for doing your part.
We appreciate your doing your part to keep us all safe.
When in public, stay 6 feet away from others.
Wash your hands often for at least 20 seconds with soap and water.
Wear a mask together. We are slowing the spread of this virus.
And together, we are saving lives.
And we're back here in Gardner Edgerton, where Trailblazers and the Raiders are knotted up at 0-0 right now. Leading off for the Trailblazers will be the right fielder, Landon Turner. Landon squares the butt, puts one down the line, and it rolls foul. So strike one. Landon trying to utilize his speed as he saw the third baseman playing extremely deep. Strike Brandon coming into this contest hitting 565. And he takes strike two at the knees. Turner down in the count, no balls, two strikes. Here in the bottom of the second. And he taps that one foul, back to the screen. Dawson Williams on deck for the Trail Blazers. And that pitch is fouled back to the screen as well. So Dawson at the plate battle. Down no balls and two strikes against this left-hander from Shawnee Mission South. Skylar Ray. Here comes the 0-2. And that ball is hit down the first baseline, and first baseman will just scoop it up and step on first base for out number one.
Now batting for the Blazers, the first baseman, number 21, Dawson Williams.
Here comes Dawson Williams to the plate. Comes in hitting 361. Takes first pitch for a ball. That pitch is low. Dawson ahead in the count. No balls and two strikes. Dawson, big swing and a miss. That pitch outside. Dawson hitting the count. Three balls, one strike. We're in the Raiders' half of the second inning. Comes to 3-1. And Dawson takes that pitch on the outside corner. That evens the count to full. Three balls and two strikes to the Trailblazers' first baseman. Here comes the pitch. That ball's in the dirt. Gets back to the screen. Dawson will take the walk. And he becomes the Trailblazers' first runner.
Now batting for Gardner Hendrickson, the third baseman, number 16, Austin Bowie.
He's going to bring Austin Bowie to the plate. Austin's trying to snap out of this. He's showing signs of snapping out of the slump he's been in earlier during the season. Got his average up to 200 now from where it was at 0.77 before. Picked up a few more RBIs. And hitting more singles. Not trying to overswing. And that pitch is fouled straight back. So the count is now even, 1-1. Tyler Butash on deck. Williams runs, and it comes up throwing, and Williams is going to be in there easily as he read the left-hander's move, took off on first contact, and the catcher had no chance to throw him out. So Dawson Williams is now in scoring position for Austin Bowie. Austin ahead in the count. Two balls and a strike. And the pitch. That pitch is just low. Austin ahead in the count. Three balls and one strike. Dawson Williams in scoring positions. Trailblazers is trying to get on the board. And that pitch is right in there for a strike. Ray able to bring that pitch up just a little bit to get the strike this time. Count is full, three balls, two strikes. And ball is tapped foul at the plate. Austin Austin trying to drive in his ninth run of the season. Ray steps off the mound. Here comes the 3-2. Man, that pitch is hit right back up the middle. The pitcher didn't make an effort to get it, and Rodriguez has no chance to throw a buoy. Rodriguez was playing deep and up the middle, and looked as though Ray had a play on that, but he kind of let it scoot through and left it up to Rodriguez, up, who was way too deep, so there was no way he was going to get buoy on that. So Williams was able to move over to third. Buoy's on base with an infield single, and when you're trying to bust out of a slump or just coming out of your slump, those are the kind of things that go well for you. Lutash now at the plate with a chance to drive in a couple, driving a run. Tyler coming in hitting at 222. Squares the butt, takes the pitch outside. Ball one. Tyler has six RBIs on the season. Go over to first base. As he was trying to catch Bowie leaning. One down here in the bottom of the second inning. Trailblazers are running at first and third. Once again, throw over to first base, and Bowie's able to get back. Sometimes the left-hander's move is hard to pick up for a runner at first base. Bowie's lead's not that big. Pitch is high. So now Tyler ahead in the count. Two balls and no strikes. Comes the 2-0 pitch, back over to run over to first base again. As Gray is really concerned with Bowie over there at first base. So Bowie doing a good job of dividing the pitcher's attention. Here comes the pitch. Butas squares the bunt. It's a squeeze. Nobody covering home. He's going to be safe, and the third baseman lets the ball roll, but it stays fair, so everybody is safe. As Tyler Butash is able to get the bunt down, get the squeeze in, drives in Dawson.
Now about it.
Boy moves up to second base, 18. And Butash is on with an infield single. So the Trailblazers is playing small ball. Take the lead 1-0 here. Meeting on the mound, Shawnee Mission South manager and his infield. Matt McMillan will be up at the plate, wearing number 18. He's a designated hitter today. Water floating like a barber, soaking up that hot sunshine. As good as it gets. So the meeting on the mound is over. Coach may have gone out, maybe giving a little advice on watching the double steal. Just trying to get out of this with a double play. And the ball is tipped and fouled away by Matt McMillan. McMillan comes in hitting 333. He's got one RBI. So McMillan looking to bring in the second Trailblazers run if he can. Here in the pitch, curveball just a bit outside, high and outside. Makes the count 1-1. Stiff breeze blowing in from right field. Looking at the flags, they're standing straight up. They're blowing in from left field. Sorry. And Ray steps off the mound. hear the very animated and vocal Trailblazer dugout. And the pitch. And that pitch is right in there. So McMillan down in the count. One ball and two strikes. Is Ray trying to get the second out of the inning here after giving up one run. Trailblazers runners at first and second on two infield hits. And that pitch is right back up the middle. So Ray gets it, goes second for one on the first, and they get the double play. So Ray able to work himself out of this inning, but the Trailblazers do put one across. So they lead at the end of two, 1-0.
And our score after two complete, Trailblazers 1, Johnson South Raiders 0.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
What is Coca-Cola? Is it an excuse to get together? Since 1886, Coca-Cola has been passing on smiles from generation to generation. We've been giving kids scholarships, like the early birds and the all-nighters. And you get to enjoy what matters most. Coca-Cola. Drink up.
Welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium, where the Trailblazers lead here going into the top of the third inning, 1-0. Zach Sanford on the hill for the Trailblazers. We were able to push a run across in their bottom half of the second inning with two infield singles and a squeeze bunt.
Now batting for Shawnee Mission Sack. The second baseman, number 15, Jackson Stone.
So that's going to bring up Jackson Stone. And Stone, first pitch swinging, hits one to Zach. Zach comes off the mound quickly and throws over to Dawson Williams at first place for the first out.
Now batting for Shawnee Mission South, the right fielder, number 14, Noah Stroer.
Noah Stroer coming to the plate now for the Raiders. Right fielder takes a strike. And that pitch is inside. And that pitch is right in there. Zach reared back and he threw it right by him. So Zach ahead in the count. One ball and two strikes here in the top of the third. Blazers lead 1-0. And that ball's tapped foul at the plate. And that pitch is also tapped foul. So Noah Stroer battling hard at the plate. And here comes the pitch again. And he swings and misses, and Tyler's able to tag. Butai's able to get the tag on him. So they're two away as Noah gets his third strikeout.
Now batting for Shawnee Mission South, the shortstop, number 5, Alex Rodriguez.
And yes, this is Alex Rodriguez, not the one we're used to seeing. But this is Alex Rodriguez from the Raiders. Alex is the shortstop. Take that first pitch high. Four ball one. The wind is really blowing out of the north here. There seems to be some kind of front trying to blow in. There should be a little snow tomorrow here in this part of the country. Some snow flurries. And that pitch is high for ball two. And if you're wondering why is it still snowing in Kansas, because it's Kansas. And that's what happens here. That pitch is high for ball three. Alex trying to become the first base runner for the Raiders. And he takes ball four, so he does become the first base runner.
Now batting for the Raiders, the left fielder, number 17, Christian Hampton.
So Christian Hampton up again for his second plate appearance. He struck out in the first. Alex is a threat to run over first base, Rodriguez is. And Mitch hits Christian right off the bat with a strike. Here comes the 0-1. And that pitch is inside. Count evens out at 1-1. Raiders left fielder, Christian Hampton. And that pitch in time, Butash fires it down to first base. And the runner's back in there safely. That pitch is fouled straight back. So, Bowie hitting the count. Well, the count is all tied up. Two balls and two strikes. Two outs here in the Raiders' half of the third inning. Trailblazers lead 1-0. Time out on the field as Alex Rodriguez ties his shoe over at first base. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Curveball slowly hit the third base. And Bowie unable to make the play over at third as Hampton scampers down the line. So he's on with an infield single.
Now batting for Shinerson South, the center fielder, number 3, Skylar Ray.
And that's going to bring up Skylar Ray. Skyler flat off the left field his first time. First pitch is for a ball. Comes the ball pitch, and that pitch is skied to center field as Wood comes in and makes the catch. So the Raiders were able to get two on, but unable to score. At the end of three, Trailblazers 1, Raiders nothing. Mentioned earlier about their trivia question that we've been trying to a new feature that we've come up with here on MSTC Sports, and this is your opportunity to actually win a $10 gift certificate to Quick Trip. This game's trivia question, this GEHS Hall of Famer member was a three-sport athlete who started and lettered all 4 years. One of his many honors includes being named to the Louisville Slugger All-American team. You can submit your answer at Facebook/MSTC Sports. And you notice that the MSTCS is capitalized. So submit your answer there to Facebook/MSTC Sports. And you may have a chance to win a $10 gift certificate if you can come up with the answer for this trivia question for this game. I will give you a hint. This player's mother was a three-sport athlete, also at GEHS. So it's in his genes. And if you know the answer, submit it to Facebook/MSTC Sports. you're a Trailblazer Nation, you will know the answer to this. It may not be just a hard question for you, but you will know the answer to it.
For the Trailblazers, the second baseman, number 3, Carson Schreck.
So Carson Schreck will lead it. Schreck will lead it off for the Trailblazers here in their half of the third inning. Carson's the second baseman. And takes first pitch low for ball one. Carson had a game-winning hit a few games ago, which did wonders for his confidence. And he takes ball two. Carson's starting to come out of hitting a little bit better as well. His average is up to 200. Takes ball three. Carson's contribution to this team is his defense. He's a solid defender at second base, and he's got speed and a very smart base runner. So here's a 3-0 pitch. That ball is low, so now Carson is on with a 4-pitch walk.
Now batting for the Blazers, the center fielder, number 1, Ty Wood.
Takes us back to the top of the lineup where Ty Wood, who grounded out the short his first time up. Runner at first base, Carson Schreck. Ty Wood at the plate. Trailblazers lead 1-0 here in the bottom of the third. That pitch hits Tyler on the leg as Tyler is hit again.
Now batting for Gardner Edgerton, the left fielder, number 7, Jake Mathur.
That's the 8th time that Ty has been hit and put on base, so he's not afraid to take one for the team. Brings Jake McClure up. Jake grounded out his last time, the third baseman. Squares a bunt, gets it down, and able to bounce. The third baseman comes up, throwing! And I'm probably going to call him out. They were good hustle down the line by Jake, but he was able to get his job done by moving the runners over to second and third. So now two Trailblazers are in scoring position with no one out.
Up next for the Trailblazers, the right field.
See here the tight play
number
over
4,
first base.
Hayden
and
Dyer.
Just able to get him. That brings Hayden Dyer up. Hayden pops it straight back. Hayden coming in, hitting a solid 500. Flat out to right field his first time. Looking to drive in two for the Trailblazers. Here in the bottom of the third. And that pitch is outside. A lot of people don't appreciate what Jake McClure did by giving up his at bat to move two runners into scoring position. That's team baseball. And Ray able to take something off of that to get Dyer way out in front of it, who's able to foul it back. So Hayden now down in the count. 1-2. Think about this Trailblazers baseball team. They are not afraid to sacrifice their own at bat for the good of the team. And there's as an example of it, as you see Dyer trying to hit the ball to the opposite field. And if he makes it out there, Carson will score from third base on that play. So another example of that. Trailblazers are not a selfish team at all. And here comes the pitch. And this ball's hit right to the shortstop. And Rodriguez comes across and throws out Dyer, but the run comes in. So, as we mentioned before, Dyer does his job. If not for Jake McClure, then Carson's not at third.
The right fielder, number two.
Hayden not able to drive again. So two away now. Landon Turner comes to the plate. Landon grounded out to the first baseman his first time. Takes strike one. Runner at third base. Ty Wood. And that pitch is smoked right to the shortstop. And Rodriguez had him play perfectly. Comes across and throws out the runner. So, Landon Turner's retired.
After three complete.
After three, it's Trailblazers 2, Raiders nothing.
My name is Ricky Gutierrez, and I'm from Eden Prairie, Minnesota. I'm an educational studies major, and I am hoping to go into school counseling. Earning a degree is important to me just because of the opportunities it opens for me for my future. I always knew I enjoyed working with kids, and that was something I was passionate about, and I originally planned to become a teacher. I realized I was more passionate about the kids and their upbringing and their development, and K-State actually offered a program that worked perfectly with my interests, and so I decided that school counseling was kind of the right path for me, just so that I could focus more on that psychology aspect and work with the kids on a more intimate level. Plans after graduation are kind of, they're exciting because I have plans to get my master's degree in counseling. Hopefully I'll have to do that. But also just that experience of getting some real life work in schools, and specifically schools in Costa Rica. Half my family still lives out there, and I would love to go spend time out there with them and just to get to experience that culture and that lifestyle, and all the while still helping people and working with kids.
For the Raiders is the pitcher, McKenna. Trailblazers come up trailing. Trailblazers come up leading 2-0 here in the top of the fourth inning with Zach Sanford on the hill. Zach has 3 strikeouts. He's only walked 1. And that pitch is low and away. Ball 1. Zach hasn't given up a hit yet. It's the 1 base on ball. And that ball is hit to McClure in left field. And he comes in, takes it down for out number 1.
Now batting for the Raiders, the catcher, number 33, Spencer Hill.
So Spencer Hill comes to the plate now for the Raiders. Spencer grounded out back to the pitcher his first time. Pulls that one fouled on left field line. Zach's done a good job of moving the ball in and out, mixing up his fastball and his changeup. Here comes a fastball, hit right to Dyer short. Dyer comes up, takes his time, throws it in the dirt, but Williams able to dig it out. So a good play by Dawson Williams over at first base on a low throw from Hayden Dyer at short. That retires Hill. 2 down now here in the top of the fourth inning for the Raiders.
Now batting for the Raiders, the third baseman, number 8, Billy Shoup.
Billy Shoup at the plate now. And he's first pitch swinging. He fouls that down the left field line.
The first baseman, number 35, Jackson Rupp.
Pitch is low in the dirt. And That pitch is outside. Comes to 2-1. That pitch is hit right back up the middle. Dyer gets a nice big hop, throws across the first, and the Raiders are retired here again. Three up and three down as Zach continues to mow them down. So at the end of 3.5, Trailblazers 2, Raiders nothing.
Take this diss and depart.
Oh, give it up for my man Grizzle. Up next, we got my boy Boogie. Give it up for Boogie. Let's go. Yeah. We got time.
Don't go breaking my heart. I couldn't Boogie, if
Boogie.
I...
Whoa, what? Stop right there.
What?
Here, eat a Snickers. You always lose your edge when you're hungry. Better?
Better. Yo, I said, give me the track, I'm finna snap. You know, timid, I ain't that. Guess your memory got snatched and you forgot that you can't rap. Yeah, you need to get some money, you look broken. You couldn't catch no water.
You're not you when you're hungry.
I ain't knowing how I'm trash, you gotta tell me.
Snickers.
What you mean. It's more holes in your...
And welcome back to the fourth inning of the Trailblazers Stadium here. The Trailblazers lead 4-0 over the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South. Dawson Williams to lead it off here for the Trailblazers. And they're half of the fourth inning. Dawson drew a base on ball his first time, stole a base, came around to score. Takes the first pitch for a strike. Good stiff breeze blowing out of the north. Big swing by Williams. Now down in the count. No balls and two strikes against the left-hander from Shawnee Mission South, Skylar Ray. And that pitch is low. Just hit the right field, and it's going to drop in for a base hit. As Williams is on base for the second time, as the right fielder hustles over to get the ball, keep Williams at first base. So the Trailblazers have a runner at first base. No one out. That's going to bring up Austin Bowie.
The third baseman, number 16, Austin Bowie.
Bowie singled his last time up, infield single. Already stolen one base today. Let's see if Ray, the pitcher, looks him back a little bit more. Open the first, and Dawson able to get back. Ray looks in. Dawson takes his lead. Here comes the pitch. Bowie takes strike one. Tyler Butash on deck for the Blazers. Going to first. Once again, Dawson back. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. Man. Bowie takes that one in right in there for strike two. So Skylar Ray ahead in the count. No balls and two strikes here in the home half of the fourth inning for the Trailblazers, who lead 2-0. Going over to first base. And Dawson Williams is able to get back again. The last base Williams stole. Ray was well into his delivery. Williams took off and stole second without a throw. That ball's tapped at the plate. Oh, Skylar Ray still ahead in the count. No balls, two strikes. Comes the pitch. Pitch is high. Game of cat and mouse going on here between Skylar Ray and Dawson Williams. Throw over to first. Highly animated dugout of the Trail Blazers. Comes to 1-2. And that pitch is fouled away as Ray took something off of that one. Bowie doing a good job of just fouling away to get another pitch. Comes a pitch, and that pitch is hit to center field, just a little looper over the second baseman's head, and the Williams is going to have to really hustle to get into second base, and he is safe as the second baseman was unable to come up with it, but then had a chance to throw him out of second base, but was unable to come up with it cleanly, which gave Williams the opportunity to hustle right in there to second base. So
now batting for Dark Angel, the catcher, number 9,
play on again with another single. Brings Tyler Buttash to the plate with runners at first and second and nobody out. As we mentioned earlier, Austin Bowie trying to work his way out of that slump, and those little hits like that, when you're going good, they fall. Here's the bunt again, pulls the bat back. Buttash getting the infield moving, takes ball one. Big hole on the left side of the infield here. And Buttash takes the pitch outside for ball two. Second baseman's playing close. The shortstop is playing closer up the middle, trying to hold the runner close. Leaves a big hole between second and short, between first and second, and short and third. So second baseman is actually playing on the outfield grass as he kind of moves in a little bit now, but he's playing very deep. Right fielder's deep, left fielder's kind of shallow. Third baseman's in at the corner. Here comes the 2-0. Buttash takes it for a ball, and Williams is able to swipe third base on the ball. So, surprise steal. Stole the base without a throw. Count is now 2 balls and a strike. Tyler having the opportunity to drive in another run for the Trailblazers. That pitch is high. So now Tyler Buttash ahead in the count. 3 balls, 1 strike. Runners at first and third. Trailblazers lead here in the bottom of the fourth. 2-0, looking to add more. Comes the pitch, and that pitch is just outside as Tyler draws the walk. So now the bases are loaded. That's going to bring up Matt McMillan, who grounded into a
now batting for the Blazers.
1-6-3 double play his last time up.
18, Matt McMillan.
Hey, Matt looking to do some damage here. In the pitch, and he takes it low for ball one. Skylar Ray trying to work himself out of a jam here in the bottom of the fourth. That pitch is low as well. Good job by the catcher to block that.
Million, the designated hitter. Here comes the pitch. That ball's in the dirt. Again, another good stop by the catcher. So now three balls, no strikes. Bases are loaded. No place to put him. Skylar Ray gonna have to come in with a pitch. We'll see if McMillian has the green light. Here's the pitch. That pitch is high for ball four, and he walks in. A run. And Dawson comes around to score. And that's going to bring Carson Schrack to the plate. Another meeting on the mound between the Raiders infielders and the pitching coach. And looks like Skylar Ray is going to come out of the ball game. While we're waiting on the pitching change here and then warm up, let's look at that trivia question one more time here. This GEHS Hall of Fame member was a three-sport athlete who started and lettered all 4 years. One of his many honors includes being named to the Louisville Slugger All-American team. And here's a hint. His mother was also a three-sport athlete at Gardner-Edgerton High School. So if you know the answer to that, submit your answer to Facebook/MSTC Sports. MSTCS is all caps. And you will have an opportunity to win a $10 gift certificate from Quick Trip, courtesy of MSTC Sports and GEHS TV. We'll give you the answer to that trivia question here sometime, next inning or so. So if you're a Trailblazers Nation follower, you should have no problem answering this question. And if you're new to the USD 231 or new to Trailblazer Nation, you may be surprised as to who this is. New pitcher on the hill for the Raiders. It's going to be number 20, Rutherford McGregor. McGregor's a senior for the Raiders. He comes in with the bases loaded. No one out. Come up facing Carson Schrack. Carson walked his first time and came around to score. And here's the pitch. And Carson swings and jabs it foul down the left field line. So Carson liking the first pitch, just a little out in front of it. Didn't quite square it up and knocked it foul on the left field line. Bases loaded here for the Trailblazers in their half of the fourth inning. And the pitch. And Carson swings and fouls that one away. So now he's down in the count. No balls and two strikes. Comes the 0-2. And that pitch is low. It's Carson able to hold off on that pitch. It looked pretty good, but just a little low. Carson looking to put a big dent in here with a single or a base hit to drive in a couple runs. Got Bowie over at third. And that pitch is low. Bowie at third. Butash at second, McMillian at first. Two balls, two strikes here in the fourth. And Carson swings, pops one up. Rodriguez is calling for it, and he makes the catch. So one away here in the fourth inning, and it takes us back to the top of the lineup.
Now batting for the Blazers, the center fielder, number one, Todd Wood.
Todd Wood coming up for the third time. We'll bat from the left side this time against the right-hander. Tyus grounding out, was hit by a pitch. Ty swings and fouls it away for strike one. Ty looking to hit one deep enough or score the runner from third base or find him a gap somewhere. Driving maybe a couple. And that pitch is high. Left fielder Jake McClure on deck. Swing and a miss by Ty Wood. So now Ty down in the count. One ball, two strikes. Pitch is outside for ball two. Raiders are in at the corner, first and third, trying to cut any rundown that comes across, but they're double play depth up the middle. Both the shortstop and the second baseman playing closer to the bag. And here comes the pitch. That curveball, and he took just enough off of it to get Wood out in front of it. Ty doing a good job of fouling that away. So all the runners will retreat to their bases. Count remains at two balls and two strikes. And Ty swings and fouls that one out of play. Ball hits the top of the scorer's booth. They were asleep in there. They're awake now. So here comes the 2-2 again. And that ball's hit right to the second baseman. Turns one, Rodriguez, and Wood is able to beat the throw. Able to drive in a run. But the Raiders do get the out at second base. So the boy comes around to score.
Now batting for the Blazers, the left fielder, number seven, Jake McClure.
Utaz moves over to third base as Ty Wood able to bring in fielder's choice. Ty with a big lead over first base. He goes already, no throw. So now two more Trailblazers are in scoring position as Ty takes off on the first pitch. McClure swings, fouls it away. Jake had a big sacrifice his last time up. Almost beat the throw out, but he had a move running from first to second over to second and third, putting both of them in scoring position. That pitch is outside. McClure ahead in the count, two balls and one strike. Pitcher taking a little bit off of that pitch, trying to get McClure to go fishing. So McGregor behind in the count, three balls and one strike. The number two hitter for the Trailblazers, Jake McClure. in the pitch. And Jake hits it back up the middle right to the second baseman. A couple of bounces. Jake hustling and is thrown out at first base. But the Trailblazers were able to put two more across. And so at the end of four, Trailblazers four, Raiders nothing. High School as the Trailblazers lead the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South 4-0 as we go into the fifth inning. Zach Sanford on the hill for the Trailblazers. So far, he's only hasn't given up a hit, struck out three, and he's only walked one. So Zach having an outstanding pitching performance tonight against the Raiders. Trailblazers able to push across a couple of runs that last inning to give him a four-run cushion. We'll have the answer to our trivia question here shortly. In the meantime, if you have not submitted your answer, go to Facebook / MSTC Sports. MSTC is all caps. MSTCS is all caps. Word sports. Get a chance to win a $10 gift certificate to Quick Trip. And the first pitch is high for ball one. This is the right fielder Strohr at the plate, and he takes the second pitch for ball two. He grounded out back to the pitcher his first time up. That pitch is also high for ball three. And that pitch is right in there. Pitch is high for ball four, so Zach gives up his second walk of the game.
Now batting for the Raiders, the second baseman, number 15, Jackson Stone.
Jackson Stone coming to the plate now. Stone struck out his last time. Squares the bunt, kicks it right back to the pitcher, and comes up throwing, and he's safe at first base as he did a good job by Dawson to keep that ball from going by him. But Stone butts the ball right back to Sanford, who turns around and throws the runner out at second base. So and here comes another one to shortstop, and Dyer goes a long way, slides, and can't come up throwing, but he makes an excellent play of keeping that ball from going to the outfield. So the Raiders have their first hit. Raiders have runners at first and second. One out here in their half of the fifth inning. Rodriguez fouls it straight back. The 0-1. Man, Buttas, good job of blocking that. Pitch is low. And that pitch is swung on. Center field. Ty Woods is coming in, makes the catch. Runner stay put. Two away here. Top of the fifth inning.
Now batting for the Raiders, the left fielder, number 17, Christian Hampton.
Christian Hampton up, he singled his last time. 1-for-2, struck out in the first. And that pitch is fouled away. And here comes the pitch. Curveball, that's going to hit the left center field, right center field, and that's going to drop. That's going to drive in at least one run. Hampton hustles into second base. And so Christian Hampton able to get one out, hit a double out there to drive in the Raiders' first run.
Now batting for Sean Mission South, the center fielder, number 3, Skyler Ray.
It's going to bring up center fielder, Skyler Ray. Man, that pitch is right in there for strike one. Pitch is low. Raiders are running that first and second. Trying to draw a little bit closer to the Trailblazers. And that pitch is right in there. Runners at second and third instead of first and second. We're just trying to draw a little bit closer to the Trailblazers. They currently trail 4-1 here to the Blazers. Comes the 1-2. And just sticks his bat out and fouls it off, fouled on the right field line. So the runners will retreat. Left-handed hitter McKenna on deck. So Zach needs to make one pitch here to get himself out of this inning. Here comes the pitch. He does. He swings and he misses. So Zach is able to shake off that one run, keep the Trailblazers up 4-1 here as we go to the bottom of the fifth inning.
Children's Mercy, we know that trust is everything.
And you can trust that we will do whatever it takes to protect the health and safety of your child.
Especially now.
So we put our plan into action, implementing safety measures at every step of the way.
Whether it's technology that allows you to see your doctor from home,
or carefully planning out every visit so you'll know what to expect.
Because we want you and your child to feel safe at our home, too.
What is Coca-Cola? Is it an excuse to get together? Since 1886, Coca-Cola has been passing on smiles from generation to generation. We've been giving kids scholarships, like the early birds and the all-nighters. And you get to enjoy what matters most. Coca-Cola. Drink up.
And we go to the bottom of the fifth inning. Trailblazers leading the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South, 4-1. New pitcher on the hill for the Raiders, junior Sam Owens.
Now pitching for the Raiders, number 6, Sam Owens.
Sam's a junior from Shawnee Mission South, right-hander. And leading off for the Trailblazers will be Kate Dyer.
Leading off the bottom of the fifth for the Trailblazers. The shortstop, number 4, Peyton Dyer.
Dyer's 0-2 today. Flat out to right, grounded out to short. Takes the first pitch down low for ball one. Raiders able to push a run across that last inning. Right in there for strike one. Zach gave up a couple of hits and able to strike out the last guy. That ball is in the dirt. And that ball is smoked to the third baseman. Dyer comes up running and just gets him. As the third baseman took a hard shot, Dyer hit the ball right on the nose.
Now batting for the Blazers, the right field, number 2, Landon Turner.
Bring up Landon Turner. Landon's also 0-2 today. He's flat out to right field and grounded out to shortstop. So I'm having a conversation with some of the coaches. We're actually looking at the third baseman. He took that shot. That shot from Dyer was right on it. And third base did a good job of standing there and letting it bounce off the front of him. But on a cold, windy day like this, it's going to hurt a little bit more. So they're looking to see if he can still continue. They're gonna look, he's gonna come out of the game. And he took a vicious shot. Dyer was right on that pitch. He didn't miss it. So while we have a little bit of time here, while they form the substitution, let's take a look at our trivia question. One more time here. Here comes our trivia question. You have one more opportunity here before we tell you who it is.
This substitution into the game for the Raiders.
GHS Hall of Fame member was a three-sport athlete who started and lettered all 4 years. One of his many honors includes being named to the Louisville Slugger All-American team. And one hint is his mother was a three-sport athlete at Gardner-Edgerton High School as well. So you know the answer, submit it to Facebook.com/ MSTCS Sports. MSTC Sports with MSTC all in caps. MSTCS all in caps. Landon Turner on the hill. I mean, at the plate. Landon takes strike one. He's 0 for 2 today as well. And the pitch. Pitch is at the knees for strike two. Jake Smith, the new third baseman. As Billy Shoup was unable to continue after taking that hard shot off the bat of Dyer. And that pitch is just low. Two balls, one strike. 4-1 Raiders. 4-1 Trailblazers. And that curveball took just enough off of it, but Landon able to foul it away. Dawson Williams on deck. Comes a 1-2. And Landon's able to sky one to center field. Center field is running, and he able to make the catch. So, two away here.
Landon's now batting for three today. The first baseman, number 21, Dawson Williams.
Dawson Williams comes up, 2 for 2. Scored 2 runs. Also has a stolen base today. Mercer Dawson's 1 for 1. He walked earlier and scored. And he singled his last time at bat. He takes a curve for strike one. Takes the curve again for strike two. Sam Owens demonstrating an outstanding curveball today. Tries it again, and this time Dawson able to pull it down the left field line. He was waiting for that pitch, but couldn't quite wait long enough. Pulled it foul down the left field line. No balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs here in the bottom of the 5th inning. Trailblazers lead at 4-1. And that pitch is in the dirt. Try to take just a little bit more off of it. Austin Bouillon on deck. And that pitch is smoked right back up the middle as Williams has a 3-for-3 day, or a 2-for-2 day. He's on base for the third time. So Williams is starting to swing the bat very well.
The third baseman, number 16, Austin Bowie.
That brings Austin Bowie to the plate. Also 2 for 2 today. Singled twice. Breaking out of the early season slump he was in. You see Williams rounding first base. He's on it first with 2 down. And Bowie hits one to second baseman. Second baseman comes up, takes his time, and throws out Austin. So at the end of 5, Trailblazers lead 4-1.
You may not hear it at first, but it's there. Echoing against limestone, drifting through the grove. You can feel it running deep beneath all that we are and do. More than a show of spirit, it's a source of energy. You can see it power leaders, fuel innovators, push dreamers into motion. On this summit, callings converge. Voices unify into a chorus, one that sounds out for good, for greatness. Our chant. Rising.
And welcome back here to Trailblazers Stadium as the Trailblazers lead the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South 4-1. Zach Sanford back on the hill for his beginning his sixth inning of work. Zach gave up a run that last inning, but he's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He struck out 5. He's walked 2. Giving up 3 hits. And Miles McKenna at the plate. Miles started the game as a pitcher for the Raiders. He stayed in as a designated hitter. Fouls the first pitch back for strike 1. McKenna's 0 for 2 today. He's grounded out to the first baseman and flat out to left field. Curveball, that ball tapped foul off of his foot. Foul ball. And on a cold day like this, he feels it. Take a few minutes to walk that one off. Apparently somebody forgot to tell the rest of the state of Kansas that it is springtime. We're expecting snow here tomorrow. Some snow flurries. Depending on which weather report you listen to, anywhere from 1 to 3 inches. Here comes the 0-2. Curveball, swung on and missed, and Buttash able to hang on to the foul tip. So McKenna's down on strikes. Strikeout number 5 for Sanford. Spencer Hill now to play. He's 0 for 2. He's grounded out back to the pitcher. Excuse me, swing. Hits foul down the right field line. He's also grounded out to short. That's also fouled off to the right side as Hill's late on that swing. So Zach ahead in the count. No balls, 2 strikes. Trying to retire the Raiders catcher. Here comes the 0-2. High. Swing and a miss. So Hill's down on strikes as well. That's strikeout number 6, Sanford.
Now batting. First baseman, number 35, Jackson Rupp.
Jackson Rupp at the plate. He struck out earlier and grounded out to short. And he, sticks it up for strike 1. Fouled it off down the right field side. Zach trying to retire the Raiders in order. And Rupp able to get a piece of that one, so he's quickly down in the count. No balls and 2 strikes. Steps off the mound. Trying to get his signal straight with Buttash behind the plate. A little smile on his face. Right. Shakes okay. Here comes the 0-2. And a little tapper back to the mound. And Zach able to throw him out. So able to retire the Raiders in order here in the bottom of the, in the middle of the 6th. Trailblazers, we lead it 4-1.
We're at the movies and we need to silence our phone. Who knows where that button is?
I don't have silent.
Everyone does, right up here.
It happens to all of us. We buy a new home and we turn into our parents. What I do is help new homeowners overcome this.
Was that an adjustable spanner? Good choice, Steve.
Okay, don't forget, you're not assisting him. You hired him. You have nowhere to sit. You have too many.
Who else reads books about submarines?
My dad.
Yeah.
Oh, those are...
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Look at that.
Your whole team can see your upper thigh. Pour that smooth roast and aim that camera up high.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
And welcome to back to Blazers Stadium here. The Trailblazers come up for their half of the sixth inning, leading 4-1 over Raiders from Shawnee Mission South. Zach Sanford's done an outstanding job, giving up one hit, striking out six, walking two, and only giving up three hits so far to the Raiders. Tyler Buttash will lead it off for the Raiders in there, for the Trailblazers. They're half of the sixth inning.
Tyler Buttash.
That was 1-for-1 today. First pitch is in the dirt. We're going to give you the answer to our trivia question here at the bottom of this inning. At the end of the sixth inning here. And Buttash swings. Hits one to center field. And it's going to fall between the second baseman and the center fielder. So Tyler's on with a single. Second
next
hit
up
of the day.
Places, the designated hitter, number 18, Matt McMillian.
Matt McMillian is coming to the plate now. He grounded out his last time, but he walked his last time. He raced on a fielder's choice. And there goes Buttash, with no chance to throw him out. So Tyler rips off second base. He's in scoring position with nobody out. The third stolen base today for the Trailblazers. Conference on the mound here between pitcher and catcher, making sure they're getting their signals straight. Now they have a runner at second base. Change up the signs a little bit. McBillion takes one high for ball one. Pitches in the dirt. Buttash thought about it, but catcher does a good job of keeping it in front of him, keeping Buttash at second base. Three balls and no strikes. Another conference on the mound here. The Raiders coach comes out to talk with his pitcher and his infielders. And the wind is really picking up here a little bit more. The lights are on here in the stadium. That wind blowing out of the north is really cool things off here. Kind of look around here, some of the fans, as they're huddled up with their blankets and their hoodies and trying to keep themselves warm on a quote unquote spring afternoon here in Kansas. Okay, the meeting's over. Everyone goes back to their respective positions. McMillian hitting the count, three balls and no strikes here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Trailblazers lead 4-1. Runner at second base is Buttash. And the pitch, pitches right at the knees. Strike one. That's the designated hitter for the Blazers today. Comes to 3-1. That pitch is low, so Matt takes the walk. Well, for the second time today, that's going to bring up Carson Schreck.
The second baseman, number 3, Carson Schreck.
Carson's walked and scored, flat out to left field. Carson swings and pulls it foul down the right field line. Got the bat head out just a little bit too fast on that one. One to Carson. Carson hits the ball to first baseman. First base goes to second base for one and not going to be able to make the throw to first as Rodriguez drops the ball on the transfer, but they're able to get this out at second base. As McMillian is forced out there.
The center fielder, number 1, Ty Wood.
Buttas moves over to third base. Back to the top of the order now. Ty Wood comes to the plate. He's got to run in scoring position with one out. Schreck takes off. Pitch is popped up. Pitcher calls for it. Infield fly rule is in effect, and everybody's safe. And then here comes Buttas to score. Wood keeps on going to second base. As the second baseman had trouble trying to catch the ball, the wind was blowing so hard. Pitcher had called for it, but it blew it out of his range. The second baseman couldn't quite come up with it. They forced Carson at second base.
Number 7.
Buttas came around to score. At the plate now. We're 0 for 2 with a sacrifice. Huge sacrifice he had earlier. Back in the third inning, he's able to move both runners up from first to second over to second and third. And now Jake pulls one down the left field. He comes in single. Here comes Wood to score. Wood dives in. He's in there and McClure goes to second base on the throw. Trailblazers pick up another run here.
Now batting for the Blazers.
It's Ty Wood comes around to score on a single.
Number 4, Hayden Dyer.
Pitch is skied out to right field and it's going to drop fair as Dyer hustles into second base on his way to third base. And he's going to be in there with a stand-up triple. The ball was blown towards the line. Right fielder unable to get there. So Trailblazers are breaking it open here in the bottom of the sixth inning as they now lead 7-1.
The right fielder, number 2, Landon.
Landon Turner now comes to the plate. And here comes the manager for the second visit, like he's going to have to change pitchers again here. Might have an opportunity now to tell who our trivia question is about. If you've been with us the whole game, you know that we've had a trivia question been putting up, and if you haven't had a chance to put your answer in, it's too late now because we're about to name the answer to a trivia question as we watch the left-hander from Shawnee Mission South warm up. If you know the answer to this, this GHS Hall of Fame member was a three-sport athlete who started and lettered all 4 years. One of its many honors includes being named to the Louisville Slugger All-American team. If you guessed Derek Bubba Starling, you are correct, and you are the winner. And we have a winner for our $10 gift certificate, and the winner is Aaron Groh. Congratulations, Aaron. You will receive a $10 gift certificate to Quick Trip, courtesy of MSTC Sports and GEHS TV. We will inbox you that information, so no need to worry about your neighbors coming by because they know you got a $10 gift certificate to try to buy them a free Zoni or something. So congratulations. Stay with us for our next broadcast on the 22nd when we have another trivia question during the girls' softball game. And promises to be another Hall of Famer from GHS TV. Okay, we have a new pitcher on the hill. It's going to be Liam Roach. He's a freshman, Shawnee Mission South, left-hander. Landon Turner at the plate now after Dyer was able to triple. There's a ground ball to second base. Landon hustling down the line, and he is just out. So Landon hustling down the line, but the second baseman able to throw him out, but the Trailblazers able to put three more up on the board. We go to the top of the seventh inning. Trailblazers lead it 7-1.
Hairline. Ain't just gonna break your dog, I'll break your heart. Yeah. Class is dismissed. Take this diss and depart.
Oh, give it up for my man Grizzle. Up next, we got my boy Boogie. Give it up for Boogie. Let's go. Boogie, we got time.
Don't go breaking my heart. I couldn't
Boogie,
if
Boogie.
I...
Whoa, what? Stop right there.
What?
Here, eat a Snickers. You always lose your edge when you're hungry. Better.
Better.
Yo, I said, give me the track. I'm finna snap. You know, timid, I ain't that. Guess your memory got snatched and you forgot that you can't rap. Yeah, you need to get some money. You look broken. You couldn't catch no water.
You're not you when you're hungry.
I ain't knowing how I'm trash. You gotta tell me.
Snickers.
What you mean. It's more holes in your...
Welcome back to Gardner Edison High School. You're in the top of the seventh inning as the Trailblazers lead over the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South, 7-1. You're looking at Zach Sanford, who's been on the hill for the Raiders. I mean, for the Trailblazers. He's pitched a wonderful game today. He's got six strikeouts. He's only walked two, giving up one run and three hits. Leading off for the Raiders, Stone. Strohr, I should say. Strohr is 0 for 2. And that pitch is hit to Dyer. It's short. Dyer hustles in, comes up throwing, and gets his man. So Dyer, good play by Dyer. Shortstop able to come in quickly, scooping and throw across his body, throw the runner out.
Now batting for Shawnee Mission South, the second baseman, number 15.
Stone's at the plate now. Stone struck out and reached on a fielder's choice. He's also scored one today. And he takes in there for strike one.
There you go, babe. There you go, babe.
Stanford trying to close it out for the Trailblazers. Give him 11-1 record. And Stone swings and misses at the little slider. Down in the count, no balls and two strikes. comes the 0-2 pitch. And that hits right back up to the middle. And Zach able to help himself by snaring that. So a shot right back up the middle. Zach sticks his glove out. Look what I found.
Right fielder, number 14, Noah Stroh.
Stroh now at the plate as the Raiders' last hope. And he swings and misses strike one. Got a chance here real quick. Talk about upcoming schedules. One you can find here on GHS TV and MSTC Sports. Two balls and two strikes here to Stroh, right fielder. Zach trying to end it here. Throws a little ground ball to third and it goes foul. April 22nd coming up this Thursday. Lady Trailblazers softball, they take on Mill Valley. You can find that action right here on GHS TV on live stream number 2. On April 27th, more softball as the Lady Trailblazers will take on Free State, the Firebirds. That can also be found on live stream number 2. And right back here on 5-11, May 11th for baseball, as the Trailblazers will take on Olathe Northwest. You can find that right there on live stream number 1. So more action coming up here on GHS TV through MSTC Sports. Hope you can join us. And that pitch is low. So that's 2 balls and 2 strikes. The Raiders right fielder. Here comes the 2-2. And he's going to catch him looking for strike 3. And that's going to end the ball game as Sanford is able to strike out the last batter of the game. Trailblazers win the game 7-1 over the Shawnee Mission South Raiders. And we'll be right back after this short break. Trailblazer Stadium as the Trailblazers have defeated the Raiders from Shawnee Mission South 7-1, raising their record to 11-1 on the season. Trailblazers, outstanding job today on defense, swinging the bats, scoring when they needed to, but they got a great pitching performance today from Zach Sanford. Our play of the game is kind of a weird play. We had a runner at first base. Dawson Williams was at first base, and Austin Bowie's at the plate. He swings, hits a little popper over the second baseman's head, drops him between the second baseman and the center fielder, and Dawson has to hustle his way to get into second base, which he does, and he's able to stay out of the single play from there. So that was our play of the game. It was a little minor play, but it was big for that particular inning. Our player of the game is going to be Zach Sanford. Zach pitched a whale of a baseball game today. Had very good command of his pitches. Kept the hitters guessing. Didn't give up. He only had two base on balls. Gave up three hits. Struck out seven on a complete game. So anytime you can get a complete game from your pitcher, that saves your bullpen. And it gives Coach Schreck more options for his next game. So as you see here, is Zach's able to help himself on a line drive right back up the middle to himself. So Zach, our player of the game. And once again, we have more upcoming events here. 422, this coming Thursday. We have girls softball as they take on Mill Valley. And you can find that on GEHS TV on live stream number 2. And also on the 27th of this month, more softball. It's Free State. The Firebirds will come and battle the Lady Trail Blazers. Also on live stream number 2 on GEHS TV. And finally, on May 11th, baseball, as Olathe Northwest will come here to take on the Trail Blazers. And you can find that on live stream number 1, only on GEHS TV. Our trivia winner also was Erin Groh. Congratulations to Erin. She wins a $10 gift certificate for knowing the answer to our trivia question, which was Derek Bubber Starling. And many of you know Starling. He's currently with the Kansas City Royals at their alternate site, but we'll be going to the Storm Chasers up in Omaha here to begin the season. So thank you so much for joining us here on MSTC Sports and GEHS TV. I've been Chuck Holmes, and we will see you next time as the Trailblazers walk off with a 71 victory over Shawnee, Mississippi.